In this video, we're going to start to create a LibreOffice Base form similar to what we did in video 57. But this time, we're going to use the MySQL backend that we've been creating in the past few videos. I'm going to click on LibreOffice and open up a new database. We want to connect to an existing database, a MySQL database. This is going to be a JDBC database connection. The database name is MySQL SearchForm, and the server is localhost. Let's test the class. It works. Put in the username of root, and we want the password required. Test that connection. I need to type in the password. That connection was successful, clicking OK. Next. And now I'm going to register the database and open the database for editing. Finish. And I will give this the name odb93 MySQL search form. I want to create a form. I will use the wizard to create this form. I want to make the filter table the first table on the form. I'm going to move everything over and select the filter ID and move that back because we don't need that. Next, we want to add a subform, and it will be based on manual selection or fields. Next. This subform will be the employees table, and I want the employee ID, last name, first name, start date, department ID, and group ID. We don't need any join criteria because we're going to make the join with variables. So I'm clicking next. The form layout, I want my form to be columnar, labels on top, and my subform to be a data sheet. I'm going to leave the data entry mode at the defaults. And I'm going to change the color to gray. 3D look, next. And then I'm going to modify the form and click finish. As a reminder of what we're trying to do, I did a print screen of ODB57, and here it is. We've got the title at the top, then our search criteria, and then our subform. So I will start at the top and make our title. Got to make a little room for our title. Selecting the label. Right click, control. We want this to say employee search form. Then we're going to change the font. We want this to be black, underlined with a single underline, and the font will be Georgia bold 20. Okay. I need to stretch this out a little more to make that fit. I'm going to close the properties for a moment. Click on the start date min, hold down shift and click on start date max. Right click, and I want to align those to the bottom. I also want to stretch these out, make them a little larger. Now I'm going to click on the group ID, stretch that out, make it a little larger, and align that to the start date max. Alignment, right. And this one here, I'll stretch that out a little bit. Let's move the department ID over. And I want to move the name up. and add in a button. This one will say refresh. And the action will be to refresh the form. We also want to change the font. I'll make this Tahoma Bold 20. And I want the font effect to be the relief embossed. Okay. We also want to change the background for this. And I will change that color to blue 11. I'm going to move the properties over. Hold down Control, click on the start date min, add shift, and click on the start date max. And I want the date format to be month, day, and the four-digit year. I want to turn the spin button on, the repeat to yes. I'm also going to add a drop down. Going back up to the top here, I'm going to select the start date min by holding down shift and clicking on the text and change that to say greater than. Then hold down Control, click on the start date max, and change this to be less than. We also need to add in our label. We want this to say start date, then I have to hold shift and hit enter between. I'll make this box a little smaller and move it with my arrow key to the right. Clicking on the greater than field, holding down shift and the less than, I want to move those down just a little so they all line up. And I'm going to put a box around these, just like we had in the picture. Going to change the color to be violet, and I also want to send this box to the back. Arrangement, send to back. I'm clicking on the start date between label, then I'm going to hold down Control and shift, click on the greater than, the less than, the group ID, department ID, and the name. Bring up our control. I want to bold all those, so I'll click on the font. On the font tab, bold, okay. Just a few more things I want to do in this video. Change this department ID to say department. The group ID to say group. And I want to change this text box. So I'm holding down Control and clicking on the text box. Right click, replace with list box. Now in the data tab, I'm going to change this to SQL. Clicking on the list control. And I want the group table, group name, group ID. Let's run this. Looks good, save. And we will do the same thing for the department. So hold down Control, select the department text box, right click, replace with list box, data. We want the type as SQL. Opening up the dialog, we want the department, close, department name, department ID. Save. And the last thing we will do is do the box that outlines all of this. And sets the center to nothing. and Resize Our Subform. Let me click on that, make this a little smaller, and move it just a little bit. And we'll pick up from here in the next video and finish off the form and this series.